In this video, we're going to focus on how we can create here in our X scale, how to wrap large arrays that we have here, or basically all these long labels, but we need to make them more readable. How can we put it in here without destroying the chart that will minimize itself? So that would mean that we need to make these labels, which are strings, we have to break them down into arrays as well. But if you get your data from your database, you have a database array value. So what we need to do is convert from there into more arrays. So we're going to use JavaScript for that. So let's start to explore how we can modify the array into our desired shape. In this video, we're going to answer one of the viewers' questions, which is how to wrap long labels from the database array in the x-axis scaling chart.js. This question is very similar to one of my other videos, except there's a level of complexity on it. All right. So what I'm going to show you here, this is the video where the question came from, which was specifically how to wrap long labels in the x-axis scaling chart.js. And if we scroll down here, you can see here the question came from Asif Mohammed Ashik. A special thank you to Asif Mohammed for asking this question. And we had some conversation before where he asked on how to connect this from the database, or at least what would happen if you would have labels from the database. And then I thought it was specifically how to connect chart.js with the PHP, or basically with the database with chart.js. However, then he specified as following, but when labels come from the database, what will I do? So here is basically what he's referring to. If you have long labels, and these labels, you need to basically break them down into readable items. If you want to really understand what this is, you have to look at this specific video here, because here we break it down. But if you get it provided, how can you modify that? So I'm going to show you exactly, because this is more a how can you manipulate an array a question than chart.js specific. However, we're going to use that, we're going to break it down, I'm going to show it, and I will show you some other chart.js option that you have, because you have a certain restriction here. The restriction is, if your label is by default very long, it will be very hard to make it readable on chart.js. Anyway, what I want to do here, first of all, is we're going to work on this. And what I want to do then is to get a default code. Go to chart.js3.com getting started. And I see, if you might see this here, for some reason, my Google Chrome gives this weird error. Anyway, it works on my other computer or on Firefox. But anyway, what we need here basically is this chunk of code that is being displayed here. And if you want to understand this code, copy this code, but also watch this specific video that explains what it does. So what we're going to do here is we're going to paste this in here. Once I paste it in here, I'm going to cut this out and I'm going to paste it in there. Save this and then refresh. So now we have our bar chart here. So we have this array here, and this is most likely the situation. We're going to copy this array. I'm going to cut this out. We're going to make here a new array, or basically we give the constant, and let's give this constant long labels equals this. All right, we have this one here, and then I'm going to echo out this here. So imagine here, and this is really a restriction you have. If your labels are by default very long in your database, the adjustments on this could be, but eventually you need to might slice certain value out or remove certain values, what we call truncate the values if they're very long. So let's create here something. As an example, let's call this here the, I'm just making up some topics. So I say here the Department of Sales in a company. They have another one, it's the Department of Communication. We have another one is the Department of Marketing. And we have here the Department of, another one, Human Resource. And let's make another one. You can see they're intentionally, they're long. The Department of Event Management and Media Communication. All right, so this is a very extreme one, just on purpose. Here, another one. Let's see here. Department of Media and Internet. And finally here, well, you get three of them. Let's say Department of Production. If I save this right now, we have an issue, of course, here. You can see these are far too long. You get this one here that's so massive long. It destroys, basically, the item. And if you watch the other video, I was referring to What we can do is to basically create array. However, in this case, you have like this, and you might say, well, the solution would be just to create this here. Put in here, and then a comma here, and this would be a string. This is the solution, but of course not when you have your data array like this. And if I save this and refresh here, you can see this starts to work nice. But of course, if you have a lot of data, you're not able to do this. So what we need to do here is we need a systematic way of doing this. But of course, the systematic way can only help you so far. For example, this one is on very long intentionally. And once it gets too long, it becomes an issue, of course, because you cannot cut it after a while. Anyway, what we're going to do here now, we're going to loop through this. What I want to do here then is basically, because it is an array, you get this from your database. So I'm going to just put this back. We don't need this. We're going to do this systematically. And remove this here. All right. So now we save that. This should be back to normal. All right. That's a single string here. So what we need to do here, first of all, we need to break this down into multiple strings. Every specific item could be a separate array or a string. And then we put it in, we combine them back into an array, basically. That's what we're going to do. And then we loop through all of these items here, so it will eventually show accordingly. So what we're going to do is basically this. Let's say here, constant. And let's say here, labels adjusted. I'm just going to say it like that. Doesn't matter what you want. Or doesn't matter how to name it, but this is just basically term that I'm going to use for now. And then we say here the following. We're going to grab this, because what we really need to do, we need to map through this. And the map method, so we say dot map, basically will loop through every item, or through every item in the array, and the array is now referred to long labels. So it will go in this long labels array, and we'll loop through this. And then here, we can start to do something specific. So we say here, and then we open parentheses, we say label, and why label? Label is just a name that we're going to give here. The reason why is just, label is just the definition of this array here. This is the most descriptive item, but it could be anything. It could be string, etc., whatever you want. It doesn't matter. Here, it does not matter what you name it, as long as you have it, have a special, or if you just give it any name that you're going to use. So in this case, every item here we call label, which is most appropriate because it is about labels here. And then we say here the following, label dot split. And how do we split it? Make a string. For every string, if we recognize that every space, we'll create a new array, or basically we'll split it based on the space between here. So every time there's a space, in this case, there will be three different items in here. So then we do that one. Once we did this semicolon here, and then all we have to do here is now to say console.log. Once we do this, we can, for example, say here this, save that. If I refresh here now, nothing happens yet here. But if I open up the developer tab, you can see now we get seven arrays. But these seven arrays are broken down again into three different items, or depending on how many spaces we have. Like this one here, about Department of Event Management and Media Communication, has seven arrays within itself. So this is an array in an array. We make every specific string now, converted it into an array here. As you can see here nicely. So now what we could do is this. So we're going to grab this labels adjusted, cut it out, put it, or sorry, cut it, copy that constant, put it in here. If I save this now and refresh, you can see here now we have this. But of course, the longer you go, it might eventually create issues. So what we could do here as well is to just reduce the font size as well. Because right now with this, maybe the font size is too large because of this one that takes really a lot of space. But I do recommend here, maybe you need to here truncate this, or you can just adjust it in your database, because in this case, this would be far too long for Chart.js. However, I'm going to show you an option here. This is the alternative what you can do as well, or not really alternative. This is an extra what you can consider to reduce the space of this, because this has too much space here. So we go down here in the skills. We're going to pinpoint the X skills. And what we really want to do is we want to reduce the font size of these items here. By default, the font size is set on 12. So what we could do here, maybe in this case, on the X scale, we're going to say here ticks, because this is regarding to the ticks, And what we're talking about here is this is the ticks label and this is the ticks mark. So here we're going to focus on the ticks label, but we can just say here font. It already recognizes that. And we say here specifically on the ticks, the font, we want to change that. So we say size. By default, it is 12. So let's put it on 8 and see how it works. Make sure you have a comma here. Save this. Refresh. And now, as you can see, it might be tough to read, but it's slightly smaller. And this is probably a bit more appropriate way to do it. So this is the ways that we can do. And maybe truncate here would be an option as well. But that's that would be probably the only emergency option, because you might miss out important data because your item might have information that you need. So these are the two best ways, I would say. Maybe this one, maybe let's put it on 10 pixels as a way. All right, so that might be slightly better. So there we are. So these are really the best options what I could recommend. So next, maybe if you're interested as well, because right now we talk about arrays, I would highly recommend you as well to look at this specific one here, how to convert arrays into data structures. So what we did here was learning a bit about arrays so far. This here shows you how to have multiple arrays, which are just single lines that you get from your database, and merge them all together into a multi-dimensional array. Fairly similar to what we did there, but far more advanced and different structure that can be useful in Chart.js as well. Highly recommended to consider this video as well to watch.